Deploy innovative ways to mitigate congestion and help your region stand out. Comprehensive analytics promote efficient utilization of public funds. Insights help prioritize cost-effective solutions for infrastructure projects, and data-based evidence helps justify initiatives and communicate with communities. StreetLight for Congestion Management provides data-driven insights that can help understand congestion patterns for a variety of planning studies. You can use metrics available via segment analysis to take a regional snapshot of congestion in a region, which can be useful for congestion management process, as well as project prioritization. In this example, we're looking at average all-day traffic in the KPDA region around Louisville, Kentucky. We can also assess metrics like speed and vehicle hours of delay. And we can delve deeper into the details by looking at different day types, such as weekdays and parts of the day, like the AM peak period. You can get more detailed information by zooming in on a particular segment. In this next example, we'll zoom into a more specific corridor. This is East Olis Boulevard in Fort Lauderdale. This is a highly trafficked multimodal corridor that runs from downtown Fort Lauderdale on the west side here to the beach on the east side. There have already been some multimodal corridor improvements on the east side towards downtown, and Fort Lauderdale has plans for more and improvements in the future. You can see when we switch this visualization to average speed that where they've already done some multimodal improvements here, the speeds are at safe speeds for a multimodal corridor. As we get to some of the unimproved parts of the corridor, the speeds do creep up into higher averages. And if we look at one of these locations in particular, we can see how that average speed differs from the 85th percentile speed, for instance, here 26 miles per hour average, but 85th percentile of 40 miles per hour. And we can also look at metrics here to identify, even though that average is 27, we have almost 10% of traffic is going over 40 miles per hour. Metrics like these can be vital to safety planning. And once the city completes all of its plans and improvements, we could come back to this corridor and rerun to see how effective the traffic calming strategies have been in a before and after study.